wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace and blessings of Allah to all of you. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. The topic is what Al-Quran says about Sawm, fasting. Before I discuss this ayahs relevant to this topic which are mentioned in the Quran, I would like to just give you the preview what you already know and some new information that people do not know in relation to fasting. First of all, the word fast, Sawm. What is a Sawm? Means fasting. People understand, and just that's a fact, that we, the Muslim community in the whole world, fast from before sunrise and at the time of sunset. And during that time, we Muslims do not eat and drink the lawful food. And this is very important to understand. The food that is permissible by Allah, that is the lawful food, not the forbidden food, the lawful food, in those times we Muslims do not eat and drink the lawful food, the tayyab, the good food, which is permissible. So in other words, fasting is abstaining yourself from lawful things. What is the purpose? So that Muslim community should gain the taqwa, or they can guard their psyche. They can guard the psyche so that where the unlawful things are mentioned in the Quran, they have the courage to overcome and start practicing the don'ts of the Quranic ayahs. The purpose of the fast. When you start practicing or start abstaining the lawful things in the month of Ramadan, or when we fast, you have the courage to start practicing the do's and the don'ts of the Allah's ayahs. That is the purpose of fast. In a year's time, Allah expects the Muslim community to fast the lawful food so that they do not eat lawful food and lawful things. This is the purpose. So that is the purpose of the fast. Secondly, normally people know only the fast in the month of Ramadan, generally. Not, I'm talking about the average Muslim, but people who are learned, who read the Quran and they ponder on the ayahs, there are other fast mentioned in the Quran other than the month of Ramadan. So you will come to know that also. Secondly, there is another type of fast which is a psychological fast. That there are things that you are not allowed to speak about them. It's a fast of not speaking. Before I was discussing the fast of food, from sunrise to sunset, not to eat and drink. Another fast is related to not to speak for a period of time when the message or the essence of Allah's ayat is clear to you. You are not allowed to speak to other people until you are convinced of that message, you believe in that message, and you practice the message. Then you share that message to the mankind. This is another fast of not speaking the message of Allah to other people until unless you are convinced of it. That is a psychological fast mentioned in the Quran. I will discuss in the ayahs. So basically there are two types of fasts. One is of food, halal, lawful food, to eat and drink, not to eat and drink from before sunrise and sunset. The other fast is a period of time And that time varies. It can be a fast of one day, 2 days, or any number of days where you are supposed to, when you got the message, how long it took you to believe and convince yourself, and then you practice, then you share the message to others. If you do not, if you are not convinced and it is not clear to you, and if you do not practice, and if you tell to other people, that is not allowed. So that is also a fast of lawful things or good things, or the basharat or the good news that is provided to you from the Quranic ayahs. That is also lawful things. All the things that in the Quran are mentioned are the do's and the don'ts. When it is clear to you, you cannot share to you to other people until unless you are fully convinced and it becomes a part of your psyche and self. Then you start talking about that essence of that particular message of that ayah. So that is a fast of not to talk about the ayahs until unless it is clear and you are convinced and you practice. So there are two types of fast. So when I read the ayahs, you will come to know, you will come to know these two type of fast. So first of all, I would like to discuss those ayahs which are related to the fast of psychological fast. Not the eating one or drinking, the other one. So that you understand, and the later on I'll discuss about. So you open the Surah Al-Baqarah 2 and Ayah 213. كَانَ النَّاسُ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً فَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ نَبِيِّينَ مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنْذِرِينَ وَأَنزَلَ مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ فِيمَا اخْتَلَفُوا فِيهِ وَمَا اخْتَلَفَ فِيهِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوهُ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَتْهُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتُ بَغْيًا بَيْنَهُمْ فَهَدَى اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِمَا اخْتَلَفُوا فِيهِ مِنَ الْحَقِّ بِإِذْنِهِ وَاللَّهُ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. Mankind was one single nation, Ummah, and Allah appointed Nabiyeen, the prophets, to give good news and warnings. And with them He revealed Al-Kitab, the book in truth, to govern between mankind in what they differed in it. And they did not differ in it except those who were given it from after what clarification came to them to wrong between each other. Allah guides from the truth with His permission to those who believe for what they differ in it. And Allah guides whom He wills towards the straight path. This ayah is referring of Allah appointing the prophets, and with the prophets the book is given, Al-Kitab, the book. This book was given to all the prophets. So Allah appointed the prophets and the book was given to them. And there are people who are differing, in not in the book, but just to wrong to each other. That's a whole big ayat. I am going to make an emphasis. The purpose of the prophets is mubashirina wa munzirin. Look, in the ayah says mubashirin wa munzirin. Fa'ba'athallahu nabiyyin mubashirina wa munzirin. Allah appointed the prophets to give good news, basharat, to give good news, wa munzirin, and to warn. Who? To mankind. So in this whole ayat, I'm just pointing, the Quranic ayahs contains many subjects in one particular ayah. So I'm not going to discuss that what happened, that differed. My main point you have to consider, what I want to make an emphasis. Allah appointed prophets. And the purpose was that they warn or they give good news to mankind. Basharat. So in other words, when the prophets came and they gave the good news, is an information of Allah to us. We are getting the information of the book, from the book, the prophets appointed, or the purpose of the appointment of the prophet was to give good news. And once you perceive that good news, what you have to do? Once you have understood the message as the essence of the good news and the warnings of the prophets, what man should do? What the man should do? So now I will explain how the good news were given to the prophets and what information was given to the prophets after the good news. Because normally when we read the ayahs and when the information comes to us, we get confused and we want to share it with other people. So we must know how and when the good news are given to the prophets so that they can further share to mankind what was the behavior of them. So first of all, I'm going to discuss the personality of Maryam, Mary, peace be upon her. She was given the good news. Remember the Basharat. I'm just emphasizing the name, the point, the Basharat, or the good news. Now in this ayah, Surah Al Imran 3, ayah 45-47, إِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُبَشِّرُكِ بِكَلِمَةٍ مِّنْهُ اسْمُهُ الْمَسِيحُ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمُ وَجِيهًا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ وَمِنَ الْمُقَرَّبِينَ. And when the angel said, O Maryam, Mary, surely Allah gives you good news, Basharat, of a word from Him. His name will be Al-Masih, Isa, Christ, Jesus, the son of Maryam, Mary, held in honor in this world and in the hereafter from those who are the close ones. Now, the whole narration about Maryam and peace be upon her, I'm going to read. But again, the emphasis is that Allah gave the good news to Maryam, peace be upon her. Yubashiruki. He gave the good news to Maryam that she will have a son. That is the good news. Basharat. You follow what I'm saying? So normally whenever the good news comes to us, it is for us that we cannot believe easily. Because of the unusual experiences that Allah we go through and what we are programmed into. Whatever we are programmed into, we cannot accept easily when the good news of Allah or the basharat of Allah or the good news that Allah clarifies in the ayahs. So same reaction what Maryam said, قَالَتْ رَبِّ أَنَّا يَكُونُ لِي وَلَدْ وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْنِي بَشَرْ قَالَ كَذَلِكَ اللَّهُ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ إِذَا قَضَى أَمْرًا فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونُ. She said, my Lord, how will be a son for me when no man has touched me? He said, likewise, Allah creates what He wills. When the order is complete, then surely He said for him, be, and he was. She said, in the human logic, which our information is less, she said, how is it possible that I can have a son when no man has touched me? Allah said, likewise, without touching a man, you will have a son. So the question is, this is a human understanding. People are cannot be convinced easily when they receive the message. So Maryam normally is trying to say to Allah, how is it possible? So Allah said, no, you will have it. Likewise, you will have a son, no man being touching you. So now I will keep on reading so to understand this is narration, an event described about Maryam, how the fast comes in for our topic. Surah Maryam 19:26-27. فَكُلِي وَاشْرَبِي وَقَرِّي عَيْنَا فَإِمَّا تَرْيَنَّ مِنَ الْبَشَرِ أَحَدًا فَقُولِي إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَوْمًا فَلَنْ أُكَلِّمَ الْيَوْمَ إِنْسِيًّا فَأَتَتْ بِهِ قَوْمَهَا تَحْمِلُهُ قَالُوا يَا مَرْيَمُ لَقَدْ جِئْتِ شَيْئًا فَرِيًّا. So eat fresh ripe dates and drink from the spring and cool your eyes. Then if you see anyone from a human, surely I have dedicated a fast for most gracious. So I will not speak to any man this day. Then she came with him to her people, carrying him. They said, O Maryam, Mary, without doubt you have brought an invented thing. So now in this ayah you will see the word Sawm. In Arabic, Inni nadartu lirrahmani sawma. Surely I have dedicated a fast for most gracious. This is the Allah says. Why? Because the information that she had received was something beyond human comprehension. So Allah said, you will fast. Whenever you see a person, a human being, and a man, you will not speak to that person because she was carrying this child. And this, the whole process, I'm not going to discuss about how Maryam and what happened. The information I'm just trying to convey is, whenever the good news is given in the ayahs, it is an amazing thing for human beings because we are programmed into certain schools of thoughts, or our knowledge of something is limited. So similarly, how Allah explained that you will fast for one day. Whenever you somebody sees you, or whenever you see a person, you say, I have dedicated my soul to the most gracious. I fast of not to speak. You follow what I'm saying? Not to speak. A fast of not to speak of the message of the Basharat or the news that was given to her. Not to speak. And you read further that what happened? Ya Taharun, ma kana ubuki imra'a saw'in wa ma kanat ummuki baghiya. فأشارت إليه قالوا كيف نكلم من كان في المهد الصبية قال إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب وجعلني نبيا. Oh sister of Harun, neither your father was a bad man and nor your mother was wrong. So she pointed towards him. They said, how can we speak to the one who is a youth in the cradle? He says, surely I am the servant of Allah. He has given me Al-Kitab, the book, and made me a prophet. Now you have to understand, Maryam, peace be upon her, was carrying this child, Jesus, peace be upon him, and she came to the people. She was given the good news, right, of a son without touching a man. She will produce. And she produced. So Allah said, you fast. Whenever you see a person, you fast. That means you will not speak. You will not speak. And when she came to the people, so they said, how is this that you brought this? An invented thing. How is this you got this child? How can she explain? She cannot explain. So she was fast. She was having a fast. So what she did is, فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ. She pointed towards the child. And he was the messenger of Allah, the Prophet, Jesus, peace be upon him. So he said that, Isa Islam said, قَالَ إِنِّي عَبْدُ اللَّهِ آتَيْنَا الْكِتَابِ وَجَعَلَ النَّبِيَّ. Surely I am the servant of Allah. He has given me Al-Kitab, the book, and has made me a prophet. Now we have to understand that whenever you are fasting of a message of the essence, like she was fasting, what she did? She pointed to her son, the Prophet. She knew this was an ordinary person. She knew by herself that who was she? She pointed to the person. And this person, Jesus, peace be upon him, clarified that I am the Prophet of Allah. Allah has made me a prophet. So we have read that Allah appointed prophets, so they warn and they give good news. So this Prophet Jesus gave the good news on behalf of Allah. That was enough for the people to be convinced. That how it happened is not the question. The question is that from the cradle this person spoke, Jesus peace be upon him. He spoke to the people and said, I am the Prophet of Allah. Allah has made me a prophet and Allah has given me a book. That means the fast of Maryam, peace be upon her, she did not speak. What she did is she pointed to the person. So suppose an ayat is clear to me, if the essence is clear to me, do I have to point to the ayat, or I started giving my own understanding and interpretations? I just have to point to the ayat. You see, people read the Quran, they understand the ayahs, and then they become, try to explain in their own words what they have understood. Any book of the world, that is the normal practice of the world. When we read any book, we try to understand and comprehend that book, and then we have got our own choice of words to explain. But for Allah's ayat is not permissible. If you have understood an ayah, you have to point to the ayats. You have to, fa asharat ilayhi. That is the message we have to understand, that whenever the essence of an ayah is clear to you, you make a habit that to defend your belief, you have to point to the ayats. So that the ayat by itself becomes clear to, will defend you, will guard your personality. You stop talking your own words, your own understandings. We people generally read the book, understand the book, and then we have got some concept of an ayah, and without referring to ayah, without quoting an ayah, we start talking. This is like this, and this is this, and that, and people are, and I have heard sermons, believe me. For 1.5, if I, standing here right now, if I say, Quran is a beautiful book, you must, all of you, read the Quran. And there are, everything is mentioned in the Quran for you to take guidance. Whatever I'm speaking, I can speak without reading the Quran. I can make a big, huge speech on the Quran by giving flowery talks, and believe me, you will not get anything. Until unless the ayahs are given forward to you, ayahs are given into your hands so that you confirm what I'm saying. That is conveying the message of Allah. There are scientific facts in the Quran. Every ayat is factual. What does it mean? Are you getting Allah's message? So people, this is a behavior. You misunderstand. You are not reading an ordinary book. It is the book of Allah. He expects you keep your mouth shut and point towards the ayahs. You cannot explain. Allah has chosen the perfect words Himself to explain the ayahs. Himself. If you think that you can explain an ayah, you are doing just conjectures. If you are, an ayat is clear to you, that means the essence, the spirit of Allah's ayah is clear to you. That is the most appropriate words translated near enough, that's it, is the ayahs. Not explanations, interpretation. You can point, of course. I am pointing to the ayahs. My lectures are based on Quranic ayahs and pointing to the ayahs. Look it for yourselves. And I always provide booklets in your hand before my speech so that you can confirm what I'm reading. So you have to listen and make a difference what I'm saying and what the ayah is saying. Drawing the conclusion is, of course, you can make, does it make sense to you? The drawing of the conclusion is that we should fast if the basharat or the good news by reading the Quranic ayahs will be given to you. And once you have understood, and when you have convinced of it, and when you believe it, and then you practice it, then you convey. So that it becomes a part of yourself. And convey means not your thoughts pointing to the ayahs, opening the Quranic ayahs and referring to it. That is how you have to get the lesson from this. Now, another fast is mentioned with Zakariya alayhi salam. Ali Imran 3 and ayah 39. فَنَادَتُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَهُوَ قَائِمٌ يُصَلِّي فِي الْمِحْرَابِ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يُبَشِّرُكَ بِيَحْيَى مُصَدِّقًا بِكَلِمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَسَيِّدًا وَحَصُورًا وَنَبِيًّا مِّنَ الصَّالِحِينَ قال ربي أنى يكون لي غلام وقد بلغني الكبر وامرأتي عاقر قال كذلك الله يفعل ما يشاء. Then the angels called him, that is Zakariya, peace be upon him, when he was praying in the chamber. Surely Allah gives you yubashiruka, give you good news with Yahya, confirming with the word of Allah, and he will be a chief and restraining or restricting himself and a prophet from those who correct themselves. He said, my Lord, how can he be a boy for me? And without doubt, when old age has reached me and my wife or woman is sterile, barren. He said, likewise, Allah does what He wills. Now, Zakariya alayhi salam is mentioned in the Quran as the messenger prophet of Allah, and his wife was barren. He prayed, there are other ayahs that he prayed to Allah that I want an inheritor from my side so that he can proceed the message of God, Allah, in, for the guidance of mankind. So he was praying, and in the salah, the prayer, the angels called him and gave the good news, again Basharat, of Yahya, peace be upon him. And he will be a ward and a chief and everything. My pointing is to the ayat is that again a Basharat is given, a good news is given, which humanly he cannot comprehend. I am an old man and my wife is barren, how can I have a child?